with me. It's Una from theharpteacher.com, and I'm going to teach you how to play the At the Drawing Music School anniversary piece, Harp 6, Hands Together. So, if you want to get some sheet music to help you out, you can go to theharpteacher.com, where you'll find sheet music with the fingering written over the notes, also letter names written over the notes. So, even if you don't know how to read sheet music, you might find this sheet music useful.
Alright.
So, first of all, let's make sure our harp is in the right key. You probably know by now the anniversary piece is in the key of D major. It's got an F sharp and a C sharp. And to do that in my harp in the most efficient way possible, I start at the bottom and I simply raise the lever of every C string, F string that I see. So I go C, F, C, F, C, F, C, F, C, F, and I'm done. If you don't have levers, not a bother. Get your tuning key and tune each F to an F sharp, each C to a C sharp. So this is what the A part sounds. So now we're going to do phrase one demo. One, two. So here is how you play phrase one. It's lovely and easy, a lovely gentle start into it. Get your right hand ready on AB, left hand ready on AA, and you're going to play your thumb on left hand with your right hand too. Try that. If it helps, you might think you're playing the two notes on the inside. Okay, so this being your outside, this being your inside of the harp, you're playing the two notes on the inside of the four notes. Okay, and then you simply play your right hand B. Give that a go a few times. So what does phrase two sound like? We are about to find out. One, two. So this is actually quite simple, once you know how to do it, of course. Anyway, you're gonna go together, right, together, right, together. Okay. So put your right hand on the C, D, E, F, put your left hand on the A, A, and you're going to go right hand four with left hand four. That's nice and easy. Then you just do the right next right hand note on its own, that's a D. Then you're going to do we're going to place your left hand back on the four. Sorry, let's just manipulate my left hand so you can see a bit better there. Then you're going to do right hand two with left hand thumb together. Play your right hand thumb on its own, and now you're going to play right hand two with left hand four. So go through that a few times. So now we're going to try for a hey, oh, a do. One and two together. So get your right hand ready in AB, left hand ready in AA, play your, and let's go. Aim, do. Easier to learn it in chunks that are relatively big without thinking about it and just letting your unconscious take over rather than breaking it down. How about you let me know what suits you? Doing it in tiny little bits where you really analyze every movement, or trying to do maybe two phrases, three phrases at a time and just feeling it? Let me know. So let's hear a phrase today. Okay. One, two. Together, right, together, right, together, right, together, right, together. And how do you play that? Well, pretty much like phrase two, you've got a nice equal coordination situation. You've got together, right, together, right, together, right, together, right, together. So it's just a question of figuring out which fingers go with which fingers rather than which hand goes with which hand. So let's get right hand ready in EDC, left hand ready on AA, and you're going to do the right hand thumb with the left hand thumb. That's nice, isn't it? Two thumbs together. Together, right hand two on its own. Right. Now place your right hand two, one back and D, E. Place your left hand thumb back on A. Play your right hand three with left hand four. Together, right hand two on its own. Right. Now play your left hand four on the G. Play your right hand two on the C. Place your right hand two on the C, I mean. Now, play your right hand one and your left hand one at the same time. Right hand C in its own, C, place your right hand 2 on the B, play your right hand thumb and your left hand 4 together, now play your right hand 2 on the B, and now play your right hand 2, your left hand thumb, together, so give that a go. How about we try falsetto tree? Figuring out the camera angle here, so let me know if it works for you or if it's not working, and I will alter my approaching feature as appropriate. And let's hear phrase four. Aim, though, together, right. Ooh, my mistake, I started putting my thumb in the left hand. Let's try that again. Aim, though, together. Car. 1, 2, 3, 4, all together. Aim, do. So this is what phrase five sounds like. Off we go. Aim, go. So, right hand gets ready with 2 on E, 1 on A. Left hand is finishing at 2 A chords and has a thumb in the higher A. You're going to play the right hand 2 with the left hand thumb. Together. Then the left hand gets ready at E chord. So you've got thumb on high E, 4 on low E. Right hand gets ready with 2, 3 on G E. Play the right hand A. Now, play right hand 2 with left hand 4. Now put right hand thumb ready in there. Place left hand 4 on A. Play right hand 3 on E. Right. Now put your right hand 2 on the D. Play your right hand thumb with your left hand thumb. Together. Now cross over and put right hand thumb on C. Now play your right hand 2 on D. Now put your right hand 2 on C, put your left hand thumb on A, and play your right hand thumb with your left hand 4. Together, and now put your right hand 2 on A. And sorry, you have it there on A, and just play it. And then you're left with the thumb on the left hand on the A, and that's ready to go back into your phrase 6, otherwise known as your phrase 1 and the repeat. Okay? I'm going to try playing phrase Hingo 3 Karakuik 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 all together for you now, right? And I'll do my best to do the together ruts appropriately. Okay, So get ready with 2 and 1 on AB. Left hand has a thumb on the A and a 4 on the A, and I'm going to start playing my rhythm. And up. So now we're going to try phrase 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then phrase 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 again. Okay? Here goes. And we have reached the B part. Let's hear what it sounds like. And do. Excuse me. And do. Right hand ready on A, D, E, left hand ready with thumb on your A, 4 on your low A. And you're going to play the right hand 3 with the left hand thumb. So think inside notes. Together. Now play right hand 2. Right. And now play the right hand thumb with the left hand 4. Together. And that is your first phrase. Let's hear what our phrase 2 sounds like. And go. Together, right. That's pretty doable. How do we do that? Apparently pretty doable thing. So put 1, 2, 3, 4 on EDCA, put left hand ready on A chord, so you've got thumb on high A, 4 on low A, and you're gonna play thumbs all together, lovely and easy. So let's try phrase 1 and 2. ADE, left hand on 4 and 1, A, and let's go. A, do. Right, let's experiment with this phrase 3 and hear what it sounds like. So, you're gonna go 1, 2 together, right, together, right, together, right, together, right, together. So how do you play this? You put right hand on 4, 3, 2, 1, A, A-D-E-F. Remember our crazy, weird interval between 4 and 3. Then your left hand is going to be ready on the A chord. I'm going to be playing our thumb first. So, we're going to start off by going inside notes together. You're going to play the right hand 4 with the left hand thumb together. Then play right hand 3, D. Then you're going to play the right hand 2 with the left hand 4 together. Now put the right hand ready with 2, 3, 4 on, 2, 3 on D. And you're going to play the right hand thumb on its own. And now you're going to play the, get the left hand ready with its 4 on the G. And you're going to play the right hand 2 with the left hand thumb. And now you're going to cross over the right hand with your thumb on the B. And play your right hand 3. And now put your right hand 2 ready on G. And now put your left hand thumb ready on G. And now you're going to play right hand thumb with left hand 4. And now you're going to play right hand 2 on its own. And now you're going to play the right hand 2 with the left hand thumb. Is it do? Let's try everything we've done so far. And do. Phrase 4. 2 on your E, left hand ready on A octave, and here goes A, do. We have actually come to the final phrase to be learnt in the behemoth. Behemoth? How do you say that word? I don't know. Please tell me in the comments. The beast. The gargantuan mammal that is the Athenry Music School anniversary release. So, two tunes, multiple different styles of accompaniment, all over a lovely 3.5 orchestral smorgasbord. And now we are on our last phrase. Phrase 4. Give it a go. Get your right hand ready on 2E, so your 2 fingers on the E. Left hand is going to be with an A octave. So you're going to play right hand 2 with left hand 4. Now get right hand 2, 3, 4 ready on EDC. Replace the 4 and the left hand back in the way. Put your right hand 2 with the left hand thumb, so play them together. Your left hand thumb ready on the high A. Now play your right hand 4 with the left hand 4. That's nice and easy. Together, right hand D is played by 3. D. Now play your right hand 2 with your left hand thumb. And then your left hand has to jump down to the E octave. Okay? Put your right hand 2, 3 ready on G, E and play right hand A. And now you're going to right hand 2 with left hand 4. Now put your right hand thumb on the F. Put your left hand 4 on the A. Play your right hand 3 in the E. Now put your right hand 2 in the D. Play your right hand thumb with your left hand thumb. That's nice and easy. Now put your right hand crossing over with the thumb onto the B. Excuse me, am I right there? No, I'm not. Put your right hand onto the C. Now you're going to play your right hand 2 and your left hand thumb is going to go back up to your A. And you're going to put your right hand 2 on the A and you're going to play right hand thumb with left hand 4 together. And now you play your right hand 2. And now put right hand 3, 2, 1 on A, D, E and play right hand 3 with left hand thumb. And that is actually not part of phrase 4 at all. That is the beginning of phrase 1 again. And I just wanted you to get used to that so you're used to repeating. we're at the end. So what you're going to do now is go to the start of this section and try playing your B part, hands together. Okay, so that's phrase 1, 2, 3, 4, phrase 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you're going to try playing along with me as I try A part and B part, hands together. Okay, so let's give this a go. Let's have some fun and enjoy it. And go. Well done. Here's the thumbs up, here's a high five, here's a hug. Well done. If you've been learning so far and you've gotten everything, I'm in awe. Mahu. So now all the hard work is done. You just get to chill out and enjoy the rest. So I'm going to put up a video where I play along with a MIDI realization of the orchestra. And that way you're going to be able to hear how your part fits in with all the other funky instruments like the trumpets and the flutes and the fiddles and the, yeah. So that would be loads of fun. Head on over to theharpteacher.com and try playing along.